to apprentice, sorry, first degree, advanced, apprentice, intermediate. Very good. All right. 100 jumping jacks.
Yes, yes sir.
Begin.
one-step, two-step, three-step, four-step, five-step, six-step, seven-step, eight-step, nine-step, ten-step, 11-step, 12-step, 13-step, 14-step, 15-step, 16-step, 17-step, 18-step, 19-step, 20-step, one-step, two-step, three-step, four-step, five-step, six-step, seven-step, eight-step, 9-step, 30-step.
Yes,
sir.
Begin. 1-step, 2-step, 3-step, 4-step, 5-step, 6-step, 7-step, 8-step, 9-step, 10-step, 11-step, 12-step, 13-step, 14-step, 15-step, 16-step, 17-step, 18-step, 19-step, 20-step, 1-step, 2-step, 3-step, 4-step, 5-step, 6-step, 7-step, 8-step, 9-step, 30-step.
Anybody feeling that power set yesterday?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Begin.
1-step, 2-step, 3-step, 4-step, 5-step, 6-step, 7-step, 8-step, 9-step, 10-step, 11-step, 12-step, 13-step, 14-step, 15-step, 16-step, 17-step, 18-step, 19-step, 20-step, 1-step, 2-step, 3-step, 4-step, 5-step, 6-step, 7-step, 8-step, 9-step, 30-step.
Roll over and stretch out your abs. You can do that. Sir, 2 sir, 3 sir, 4 sir, 5 sir, 6 sir, 7 sir, 8 sir, 9 sir, 10 sir, 11 sir, 12 sir, 13 sir, 14 sir, 15 sir, 16 sir, 17 sir, 18 sir, 19 sir, 20 sir, 1 sir, 2 sir, 3 sir, 4 sir, 5 sir, 6 sir, 7 sir, 8 sir, 9 sir, 30 sir. Bend forward, touch your toes.
Yes, sir.
1 sir, 2 sir, 3 sir, 4 sir, 5 sir, 6 sir, 7 sir, 8 sir, 9 sir, 10 sir, 11 sir, 12 sir, 13 sir, 14 sir, 15 sir, 16 sir, 17 sir, 18 sir, 19 sir, 20 sir. 1 sir, 2 sir, 3 sir, 4 sir, 5 sir, 6 sir, 7 sir, 8 sir, 9 sir, 30 sir.
Switch.
Yes, sir.
Reach up. And forward, touch your toes.
Yes, sir.
1 sir, 2 sir, 3 sir, 4 sir, 5 sir, 6 sir, 7 sir, 8 sir, 9 sir, 10 sir, 11 sir, 12 sir, 13 sir, 14 sir, 15 sir, 16 sir, 17 sir, 18 sir, 19 sir, 20 sir. 1 sir, 2 sir, 3 sir, 4 sir, 5 sir, 6 sir, 7 sir, 8 sir, 9 sir, 30 sir.
Yeah. Oh. Okay, and bend forward, touch your nose, your toe, as far as you can go.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
One, sir, two, sir.
Three, sir, four, sir, five, sir, six, sir, seven, sir, eight, sir, nine, sir, 10, sir, 11, sir, 12, sir, 13, sir, 14, sir, 15, sir, 16, sir, 17, sir, 18, sir,
19, sir, 20, sir.
One, sir, two, sir, three, sir, four, sir, five, sir, six, sir, seven, sir, eight, sir, nine, sir, 30, sir.
See the angle looks wide apart, lift yourself up and turn to your right.
Yes, sir.
Shift to the other side.
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Back to center, see the angle like wide apart?
Yes, sir.
All that back to you?
Sir.
One, sir.
Two, sir.
Three, sir.
Four, sir.
Five, sir.
Six, sir.
Seven, sir.
Eight, sir.
Nine, sir.
Ten, sir.
11, sir.
12, sir.
13, sir.
14, sir.
15, sir.
16, sir.
17, sir.
18, sir.
19, sir.
20, sir.
1, sir.
2, sir.
3, sir.
4, sir.
5, sir.
6, sir.
7, sir.
8, sir.
9, sir.
30, sir.
Reach to one side.
Yes, sir.
Quick question. Anyone do push-ups at home?
Yes, sir.
How many do you usually do? 12?
Like, set to 12.
Set to 12?
10.
10?
10.
10? Is 10 easy? Can you do one set of 10 and be okay? Okay.
Change the time, right?
Say again?
Change the time. Like
what do you mean?
How long you're going down, if you're going slower, faster.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's it. Can you increase it to 15?
Yes, sir.
Try to get it to 20. We can do 20 straight.
Yes, sir.
Reach to the other side.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I say that because if you, for sake of improvement, of course, when we do up here, we're just warming up. Right? When you're working out and improving, you'll do things a little differently. So if you've ever heard, the one that burns is the one that counts. So you don't, in certain gyms or with certain partners, when you're lifting weights or any type of workout, they don't count 1 to 10.
Because 10, the 10th one starts to hurt. The ones after, so they count the few that you do after that. So they count five. You did five push-ups from the 15. Does that make sense? Because those five made the difference. Those five improved your endurance. Those five pushed you past your point, reached both sides. So when you do your push-ups and you get to 10, see how many you can go past 10. One, sir.
Two, sir. Three, sir. Four, sir. Five, sir. Six, sir. Seven, sir. Eight, sir. Nine, sir. 10, sir. 11, sir. 12, sir. 13, sir. 14, sir. 15, sir. 16, sir. 17, sir. 18, sir. 19, sir. 20, sir. One, sir. Two, sir. Three, sir. Four, sir. Five, sir. Six, sir. Seven, sir. Eight, sir. Nine, sir. 30, sir.
Last stretch, feet straight out front.
Sir.
Then one leg back and lean back.
Yes, sir.
So say I do three sets of 10 long, and I want to increase that, so I do five extra on those three sets. The first time I get eager to try to do a few more, like get in and try one more set of 10. After that third set, just stick with your goal. Stick with what you set and do that. Because sometimes you'll get in the mode, and your body will get heated up, you'll start feeling young again, because the more warm you are, the more young you are. You know, I can do that. It's like, well, just slow down. Plan on starting with. That's why a lot of CrossFit, they write it down on the board. Mm-hmm. You can be self-sufficient and have set goals. Mm-hmm. So, yes, sir. Because I met two guys, older guys, that started doing CrossFit, got super, super ripped and in shape, and ended up at the doctor's office for. Like one whose wife was a fourth degree, going on fifth degree here in Tai Chi. He was going to CrossFit so much that he was going for hours at a time. He was breaking his muscles down so much that they weren't building up. And at his age, that just wasn't doing good for his muscles, right? So the doctors were like, all right, cut it out. Like, you're not 20 anymore. Your body doesn't heal that fast. I understand you enjoy it. The other guy, his son took classes from us. His wife came in and was like, yeah, he got sent to the, went to the hospital because he had too much creatinine in his blood. So his body swelled up like he had an allergic reaction. And it was from getting ready, getting pumped. I don't know if it was from taking pre-workout or if his body naturally created much more than it needed to, but he was just doing too much at the CrossFit. Working on the kicks. Let's do our warm-up drill, and then we'll get on pads. And did anybody have any questions before we get going? No? All right, let's go ahead and run our deal. There and back twice.
Yes, sir.
Try to get loosened up, opening up the hips, swinging and pivoting right. I'll start it off. Here. Even though in the combination we're doing front leg round, we're going back to round for the sake of momentum. Right? So here, boom, boom, boom. Don't forget to spot. Try to look up and out. It'll help a lot. Make sure you're spotting though, because you'll get dizzy. Boom, front, front, front.
right, oh, it's a thing. So, imagine, this is also why I have you do this drill, imagine doing some spin kicks in the rain, and you disorient yourself. It happens. It happened to me. It happened. You go, boom, boom, you weren't quite ready to do it, and just like, you already kind of landed, and you shook your face real hard, it's like, you gotta kind of reset, get yourself together, right? You lose your balance, or you mess around and do it, wow, get the point. That's the best when you actually get the point. They're like, great, they're like, yes. All right, now, you get the reset. And then points line, that's what they'll do. Is that their next point?
One
more, right?
Sir.
Think of orienting yourself like you're gonna kick. So lean away from your target. The leg should lead you. Good. All right. Take a quick break. Come back and we'll be on pads.
Yes, sir.
I was looking for the official list of all the combinations. Yeah, I'm gonna have to.
That was the last one, I think that
was. Say it again?
That was the last one, I'll grab
some. Oh, no, yeah, I was being there for the school, I'll grab some. Yeah. Right? Alright, so let's see, I'll finish the way I want to finish this thing. Boom. Pressing because the hand is here, I'm going to go around and then I'm going to pull, ridge, and then as I pull in, I'm going to pop, boom, that's the point. Now, go ahead and pop that and sink. Real boxer style, so come up real tight with the front hand and hug yourself. Yes, and then back. Good, okay, let's do it again. Front leg round, reverse, boom. Don't switch your feet.
Oh.
Yep, keep your feet. Go here. Reset. Set. Front leg round. Reverse side. Front leg, front hand. Ridge. Back punch. Yes. Y'all like going to sleep. That's how tight, just don't tilt the head. With the glamour shot. You know. Oh yeah, what's up, boy? Go ahead, give it a try on your own. See how it feels. Imagine fighting somebody really tall when you aim with your ridge hand. Boom, boom. Right?
The ankle.
Yeah, because well, you're squatting. So even if I was fighting, we're not. I mean, you're taller than I am. But even if I, right, I'm naturally going to be here. So when I ridge hand, I'm going to go there. When I back punch, boom, right to the body.
Yes, sir.
Now from here, center, I want you to keep your weight on your back leg. Right, so you just did your side kick. Set it down, but don't shift forward. Now shoot off the back leg and bridge game. Don't shift forward. Keep back. Right, because you don't want to hit you.
Okay.
So there, because you can also kick him again.
Right.
Right. So boom. And then right after here, you're gonna pivot. You're gonna push and pivot.
Okay, so that's when you're actually
right,
kind of going into.
Okay.
So is the bridge hand more just like to set it up?
But you get more. Yeah, but it's more of a setup, right? Because really, you don't have to grip them. You can just go like this.
Right. Just get them to react.
And they'll go like this, and you go boom right in the body, real hard.
That's okay. Got it.
Hit the air sense.
Yeah. But their hands are occupied. Get you a straight shot. Yes. Yep. Traditionally, these would end with a back punch or a back rear hand. Okay, T.
Okay.
Okay, now come watch it from here in the mirror.
Sir.
When you see something from far away, you get a better idea of things. Okay, so I'm going to show you, I'm basically going to emphasize what I just showed Mr. Nelson. And that is the weight distribution, how it doesn't change when you're doing these kinds of spins, right? So if I turn and I kick, boom, watch where the weight is. Where are my shoulders?
Back.
Right, now watch it. When I turn and do my reverse side, look where the weight is. Front hand, rich hand. Back punch.
So until the last punch, your weight is...
away from that, because they can hit you. Now, once you get to the third or fourth move, commit. You have to commit. Don't fade out. If you do 1-2, distraction, maybe get them on the second one. More than likely, you'll miss it there advance. 1-2, distraction. 3, it's a setup. These are setups for this one punch.
Right.
Yeah, they're not going
to
let me get.
Just to get one.
And in Black Sash, that's how I have to think. At Black Sash, you have to be thinking 3-4 moves ahead. I didn't act right. So 1-2-3. That was the third one. I was trying to hit you with my right hand the whole time. I wasn't even thinking about the first one. Right? In advance, it's maybe 2. Practically, because everybody thinks y'all are. It's real life, to be honest with you. Practically, y'all don't go that fast. Y'all go 1 and 2, and that's fine. So let's set it up. I want you to turn and we'll run it this way. So put your right foot forward. Do your first technique, set the foot down, and then look. Look at yourself in the mirror. Go round kick, and then look over your, as you look over your left shoulder, look at where your body is. Now, you got your side kick, boom. Set it down, see where it is. Now, you're gonna push, like that. Watch it again. Same with offense, lift, push. Yep. And when you do that, once you put the foot down, that's when you reach in. And then now you're gonna pull it back. Now keep that left hand up by your cheek though. Real close. So we're gonna take a break here in a second. I wanna work with Mr. Hogan. I want you to just stand here, go for your sparring.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm here, I'm going around. Boom, he blocked it. Go ahead, scoot back a little bit. Boom, I'm going after him, keep going, move back. Boom, I missed that one, he blocked it. I'm gonna stand here. I'm not gonna give him my weight because I might wanna kick him again. Once I go here, he could round kick. Boom. Now, he tried to get the head, of course, but as soon as he goes there, go ahead, round. So I want you to think of timing, right? You gotta think of what he's gonna do to react and then try to think about how you can set some moves up to get him confused. Or his hand occupied, not confused. He's just occupied.
Yes, sir.
Occupied meaning if I go like this, you see how he did? He reacted. That's all. His hand is occupied now. I can get in there, right? Right? All that is him occupying his hand. As soon as he goes from where he was to me, now I'm setting him up for the next thing. Alright?
Yes, sir.
Alright, take a quick break.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
in trouble.
Oh no!
Took your desk outside.
I didn't move furniture. I'm sorry.
That's not my job.
You better call the janitor. I'm sorry, ma'am. I'm a student. That is not my job. I didn't set him up like this, did I? Now, out of my face. I didn't have nearly. That would have been a nice little addition.
Shoot.
Okay. Let's work past. It's difficult to do long combination like this sometimes, but let's think about it. So if I'm holding the pad, so you have to hold it like this, one flat. That's too fast. Yeah, you need two pads. There's enough of that. Go ahead. I'm gonna be Jillian's first partner. Jacqueline B is the old partner.
Sir.
It's a lot to think about, but I got on early class about, you know, of course, being focused tack holders.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
sir.
Let me go with Mr. Hogan first. Let's give everybody an example.
Yes, sir.
All right, so we're going to go round kick, side kick with this one.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to do the other two with this one. Okay, so round kick. Side kick. Back and, front hand, bridge hand. Back. Perfect. All right, so really you only need this one for the bridge hand. So you're gonna have this one up high.
Yes,
so first is here. Round one, reverse side. Two, ribs, three, four, nine. Make sure you're pulling that fist boxing back punch.
Yes, sir.
Okay, bow to your partner. Y'all gonna run long ways here in the front, that's all right. Next to us, yeah.
And reverse.
Okay, reverse.
Sure.
So
it's still warm for it.
Yeah. Front leg round.
Start with, good, yeah.
It's front leg round. The only reason we were doing back leg is for the drill. So yeah, front leg round. Okay, reverse side.
That's confusing.
I'll go slow. Front hand, bridge hand. Try to
go slow.
Back punch.
So you can get the
yeah.
Pads, and then we'll pick up.
Right about. There you go. One. Two. Three. Oh, yeah, that was for the early part, because you know that. Boy.
Opposite of what I was doing. So,
Okay, so.
You're gonna do your wrist hand, you're gonna lean away.
I know, it's surprising, those things get like, popped.
Two, lean away. So take stance, spread the feet. Hop in the knee.
Wrist hand.
Lean forward and away. Yeah.
Cause you're coming.
But not there, or wrist hand.
Yeah, I'm so used to like,
going and not being.
Yeah, does that make sense? Do it like that.
It's stuck in there, and then you're just totally.
No, it makes sense.
Yeah. No worries.
Do one more switch.
Okay, so this one.
Yeah, it feels more practical than to be.
Cause you're not thinking of where she was before, a real kid, and it was not here.
Competition, you gotta take your knee or something.
Right, exactly.
Move that other one over.
Keep it on top of that one.
Yeah, keep that one on top.
Also, we used to do.
Yeah, okay, D.
Do you think?
Now, very quickly, of course, remember where your pads are, set them down for a second. We're gonna practice some more, turn toward the mirror, and we're gonna work on just alignment a little bit. Just like alignment, so turn your ready stance, right? So I'm here. For a round kick, I might start here, but I'm gonna be here by the time I'm ready to kick. Does that make sense?
Yes,
so I'm gonna slide in to a T, of course. Round kick, boom. Set down, turn. Make sure my hips are open and push straight off that line, side kick. Set it down. And when I set it down, you're setting it down a little further back so you can open your hips. Now I'm still back. See, remember the weight's back? Now I'm gonna go ridge. Keep it out for a second so we can see. Now I have to twist. I have to bring my weight back. So remember I'm leaning this way, I have to bring my weight here and then turn. Does that make sense? So I'm here. Hips come back, turn. Boom, stay here. Check your pose. Is there space between the feet, like a bow stance? There you go, and then get the back heel up. Bah, it should pop out a lot. Good, okay, now come stand behind me, and look how much the heel pops out. Come stand right behind me.
Uh-huh.
You see where my knee is?
Yes, sir.
So when you turn your body like that, the foot doesn't have a choice. It naturally does it. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now watch. Yes?
Yes,
so same power, same deal. Just pop that heel out, right? Because what if it, bah, you're going to want it to continue.
Yes,
okay,
sir.
Go ahead, try it again. Open your stance, pop that heel out when you throw that fist. So go round, I'm open, turn around, boom, strike, set, ridge, and bust. Yeah, Let that knee bend so it's got some, bend the knee, this one. Yeah, collapse. Yeah, like that, just like you just did, yep. Uh-huh, feet together. Keep that fist on that cheek. Okay, try it again. It's a lot so much to think about, right? It's like, what do I do with this part of my body? And this part, and this part, and this part.
Aren't you glad we're gonna have 3 yards?
Yeah. Uh-huh. And then relax yourself. Relax. Best thing you can do as far as relax, and you'll see me do a lot of this type of stuff. It's because I'm, so relax. You know how to do a round, so throw a round. Boom, that's your round. Pivot, relax. Look, side kick, spot. Set it, relax. Ridge hand, stay here, relax. Pull and twist, relax. Relax the body. Reset. So when you see boxes and they're going, who's seen that? They're not punching fast, hard, they're relaxing. Because you get efficient motion when you relax. If you want to move fast, you have to relax. Bruce Lee said it. So if I want to go here, and instead of, you see, it's significantly slower because I'm resisting my own strength. I'm relaxing all the muscles necessary, and then I'm tensing on impact. Relax, relax, relax. Tense, relax. Tense, relax. Tense, relax. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Let's try it again. Relax. Turn. Reach. Reverse. Set. Good. Yeah.
I have too much of a gap on the last part.
Let me see.
My legs.
You just might. Bring the foot up. So it's a bamboo step. So when you do your ridge, look. Notice how this foot came with it?
Uh-huh.
I pushed, but it came with it. Same thing here. It can't stay. It doesn't stay there.
I see, but okay.
Yeah. Once you pushed off, there's no more power in it. I just pushed forward. So slide it up so I can be balanced still.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, you did what you needed to with it. Yeah, right. He was like, when you throw it too hard, it's like, whoa.
Yeah, yeah.
You only need a little bit. You only need a little. So push off. You would have got him by then. All right, go to try.
Yes, sir.
Look at yourself in the mirror. Don't look at the floor. Hit yourself in the back of your own head. It'll help stop your hand from going too far.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, hit yourself.
Yes, sir.
Yes. I got something that's going to help you all sidekick here in a second, too. Everybody's doing it a little bit. That's all right. The spinning stops at the side kick.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, watch. So everybody thinks they're still spinning when they're kicking and you're not. So notice I'm not spinning now. Am I? I stepped and then I pivoted, yes?
Yes, sir.
So then when I kick, I don't need to spin in my kick. It makes y'all straighten up. Notice? Huh, y'all like, ah, because you're trying to hurry up and get to the next thing. You didn't need to do that because sitting up like this, it's not going to help you with this.
True.
I purposefully put the front hand, rich hand prayer, one, because I like it, but two, because I want y'all to orient your body different. So we got ground. Look, this is it. There's no more turn. If I want to do it again, if I want to step back and turn back to this leg, you give them your back, because that is all that they can't hit.
Mm-hmm.
It's a tournament thing, but it also helps with form and actual like striking. So after you go around and I'm standing here, from here I look and this is where I kick from. Don't turn more. Stay here.
Nice.
Y'all are trying to see more. Just look. Boom. Okay, now try it. Go around, pivot, and then just look. Pause for a second and then look. Bend more. Bend more. Lean this way more. Now look. Now go. Keep the body. Yes! It hurts the hips less.
Yes.
I'm all for that.
Stay there. Yes, sir. Uh-huh. Now, the last thing that I'm going to talk, which we'll pick up on next class if you all will help me remember. We got boom. Oh, sorry. We got one. This is good. Y'all good on that? We got pivot. Y'all are getting better at this part. And we just went over boom. I need y'all to understand your sidekick can never retract back anywhere near your butt. This is what I'm saying. To get here. When you do that, you take away your power to pivot. This is what I mean. After I go around, set the foot down, and I go side, my yank back is how I pivot. Did you notice? If I wanted to pivot that way, right? Boom. That gets me back balanced. If I wanted to do a back punch, which is the way we traditionally end some of these, right? That helps me get to where I need to be. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay. So next class we'll practice pulling that, because when you sidekick, boom, it should come back the same track that it went, just in case you have to do it more than once. Boom, boom. Watch. Boom. Okay? So come same track after you away from the bottom, pull it back, and that'll help get you to the. Alright. Grab your swords.